So, friends, yesterday, let me try to remember what we did. So yesterday, we, genau, I need to collect a herb, black root, I think, so we can talk to our god. And because of that, we went to the western part of Driftwood. Then, yeah, left from Driftwood, also west from Driftwood, into some kind of forest. There we found a skeleton. Yeah, we found a lich. We found a lich. And we talked to him. At the end, we helped him and I got some reward. Then we found another skeleton lady. She wants to have a book about exploding skeletons, I believe. And we could trade with her. And then we fought with some magisters and helped the sorcerer. But of course, that the sorcerer is helping us, we need to do more. We also found a witch, but she is so strong. So we went away. yeah, there we stopped. We talked to some bears. We also talked to some troll. One troll. That was more or less it. What we did. Oh, wait. I remember. Elena, you wanted to ask what companions I used in Divinity 1. Wait. Okay, I think Madora and Jahan. Yeah, these two. Yeah, I believe I had these two. What I remember. Yeah, I think so too, Dino, but maybe in the future. Oh. Okay. We wanted to do, let me think, I had some great plan. Ach so, yeah, we wanted to explore the rest of this map. So here is this witch, she's too strong. We have to wait a little bit to get some more level ups. We did not check what is here on the map. So maybe we start here. And then we go here to the left hand side. I was not here either. And we did not go to the water. So let's go first here up. And then from there, we explore this corner. Here in the bridge is the troll. And he wants some kind of money. And yeah, so we explore here. And here. And then we go here. Yeah, it should be part 29, I believe. Cool, Jahan. Did you also use him? Also, I think you are going to need 54. Yeah, I'm not sure. Also, I was thinking that we probably have over 100 hours when I'm done with the game. It was my guess. I was thinking today about it and I was like, I think we probably need 100 hours or more. Okay, who is here?
I see a cage, and in it, is that a demon?
What? A demon? A demon?
I suppose even you don't.
Oh, he's called Jahan. Is it the same from the first one that we just talked about?
The master?
Or is it a different one?
The crawler?
In the near distance, you see a man, though shadows obscure his features. A faint, guttural chittering emanates from a cage before him.
Is it the same? And we just talked about Jahan? Is it the same guy? It's the same one? He's very old now. Oh, that's cool. that's funny that they brought him back in the second game. That's nice. That's funny.
This is him. He can help me. He can...
Oh, is he the demon dude? Oh, it's a demon coming out now.
Losa's eyes suddenly fill with inky blackness. Gray veins appear beneath her skin.
Walk away.
She shakes her head. Her color returns to normal.
I'm running out of time. I think that man is Jahan, the demonologist. Oh. I need to talk to him.
Okay, Jehan, not Jahan. Okay. Tell you go ahead, tell you business, here's more pressure. Yeah, tell you go ahead.
She throws up a salute and laughs low, but worry sparkles behind her eyes. She walks towards the mysterious figure, who turns towards her with narrowed eyes.
So I did his story in the first one, but I don't remember Selena. It's too long ago. I don't remember.
Keep your distance. I recognize that particular shade of darkness in your eyes. Why do you seek me?
You're Jehan, the demonologist. I heard you could help me. Please, I must be free of it.
Jehan stands back from her, his body tense. He stares into her eyes a long while, saying nothing.
I've heard about you, Losa. You're the amalgam too hideous to contemplate. One who has a demon coiled around her god-woken heart. Its grip grows stronger by the hour. Its voice and yours become ever more indistinguishable until, ultimately, it's your voice no longer. But not just yet.
He walks toward her. They talk in low tones. Jahan's face is vivid, insistent. Losa's is set in a determined frown.
Do as I say, Losa. Hurry now. It won't be long.
They shake hands, Jehan clasping Losa's hand in both of his.
You'll see. I'll be back before you know it. The Advocate doesn't stand a chance.
Losa turns to you.
So, we have a job.
Tell you all ears? Tell it sounds like she's job, not you. Tell you can discuss it later. What is the story of the first game? Selena, can you sum it up in some sentences? I don't remember. I just know I loved it and was great. So, that I know. But I don't remember. Cabby's be helper, of course.
It's like this. Jehan can help us. He can teach us how to control more source, just like that. All we need to do is a little favor for him.
Okay.
There's a place to the north called Blood Moon Island. I guess it's been more or less lost to a demonic presence for some time now. There's a fellow there, goes by the Advocate, and our new pal Jehan would like to see him taken care of. We take care of that, and Jehan helps us control more source. And after that, he may even be able to help exorcise what ails me. Sound good? Of course it does.
Wonderful.
She turns away before you have time to answer.
Excuse me, you travel with Losa, do you not? We need to have a word, you and I. I suppose I don't have to tell you her condition is rather dire.
Then you're quite aware you've had one in or two with the demon of hers. You certainly understand the gravity of the situation. All the more reason to help her get a demon gun fast. Confined that you sometimes wonder whether you made the right choice in such companion.
You're no stranger then to her demon-wrought idiosyncrasies.
Idiosyncrasies?
The thing inside her is voracious. It's a testament to her strength that it hasn't long since consumed her whole. Perhaps that's because she's godwoken, just like you are. The fact that she's godwoken is what's saving her, but may also be the very thing that spells the world's doom.
Okay, so Selena is saying the story of Jehan is, in the first game, Jehan made a deal with a demon in Divinity 1, and then he realized that was a bad idea. Stimmt, I think I remember now a little bit. The payment was the demon gets his soul after 1,000 years. In Divinity 1, the source hunters helped him to get rid of the demon, so he keeps his soul and the bargain is no more. In Divinity 1, he was very close to that 1,000 years of age. He still does not age. Ah, right. Can you summarize the story of Divinity 1? Just a little bit for Zucker. So, from the first game, he only played Divinity 2.
Do heed me when I say that under no circumstance must she be allowed to ascend to divinity. The demon, not she, would be a god. It would bring about the end of time and space and all creation as we know it. I say this to prepare you for the worst. I say this to prepare you for the kill may come to pass. You must be ready to be the death of Lusa. Should she come close to ascension, you may not hesitate. Stand ready to end her, even if it breaks your heart.
Okay, oh. Say you understand, Tam, you could never hurt Lose. Naja, I say I understand. Oh.
Then practice the moment in your mind. For hesitation will mean annihilation. There may be more I can do for you. Come find me if you are interested in growing the source inside you. You may find that new strength will soon become essential. How fares the hunt, my friend?
Ask if you can give any insight as far as reaching the island is concerned.
Death fog obscures any approach and hangs thick over the collapsed bridge that led to the isle from the Driftwood Road. There is more than the mist alone there, though. Magic that evades my eyes. I also spotted a sloop further down the shoreline. But of course, a quiet afternoon's boating trip will be quite ruined once one hits death fog shrouded waters.
So you're interested in learning more about the nature of the island?
It is a place of irony, if you will. Once the site of an academy dedicated to the art of demon hunting, now the remnant of a dream sliced open into nightmare. Rumor has it, an exorcism went wrong there long ago. And for a short time, a great demon stood unopposed. Had it not been for Dr. Deva, the entirety of Reaper's Coast could have looked like Blood Moon Island looks today. He contained the demon and its bloodspawn to the doomed shores of the isle, surrounded it with death fog, and never looked back.
How can we go on the island if everything is full of death fog?
I met him once, during a soiree in Arx. Quite the eccentric is Dr. Deva. But then again...
He looks you up and down.
Aren't we all?
Ask how he knows how you got woken.
He smiles, like one would at a child, asking about the birds and the bees.
I know, because I've known others like you. Those whose fates are chained, for better or for worse, to that of the gods themselves. I have battled the foe of foes, and conquered it. For a while. I have sat in perfumed gardens with the source herself, drank life from her very lips. I have seen well over 2,000 springs, and will continue to do so until time itself closes its weary eyes.
Oh, he even says that he's 2,000 years old. You're right, Selina. He even says it here. Elisbe has a great accent, or? I don't know what kind of, I would say Spanish? But I have no clue with accents, but I would now say Spanish. But I don't know. So, I don't know. But it would be my idea of his accent. But I think he sounds lovely.
Trust me. I know what you are. And what you can be. May you wander in wisdom.
Yeah, genau. So, Sina saying, so the first part is about... Zucker, you play source hunters, genau. And you choose if you do your job or you hunt all sorcerers. You know, but that would be our job, or? To hunt all sorcerers as source hunters. But we can also decide not to do so, oder? You are sent to Cecil by your order to look into a murder that is thought to be done by a sorcerer. But of course, it's not a straight line, and you fight things that may not change the world. Yeah, at the end, you have to rescue the world. And the Bracchus Rex, who you heard, so in Divinity 2, we hear a lot of Bracchus Rex. Genau, he's there. Yeah. So it's like a little bit of pre story of Divinity 2, maybe, like that. And you should read, also you should play it, it's really good. The stories are independent from each other, yes. I would not say they are connected, but of course, you have now some stuff like Bracchus Rex, he's in the first part. And this guy here, he's your companion, if you want, in the first part. Jehan, he was my companion in Divinity 1. I had him and the lady. So you create in Divinity 1, you create two characters. And you play two characters. And then you can get two companions, if you want. Okay, what does he have? Oh, here's necromancy stuff. Belly harpoon. Lifesteal. Ooh. Elven bow. Yes, you can choose if you're nice or just do your job hunting sorcerers. You know, I was nice. I did not hunt sorcerers. I was nice. And also in Divinity 2 here, I told you, when you remember when we went this tower with this skeleton dudes? This three skeleton guys where you can decide to free them? There we talked to a well. And in Divinity 1, there you help, there are also this well and there are brothers. And you can help them too. So there are some loose connections, I would say. Jahan is also a king that left his kingdom. He describes it and it sounds a lot like Arabia. A kingdom in a desert. Ah, okay. Want to play this game, but I only have a PlayStation 4. I read a lot of comments saying it sucks. No, no, it's good, Lisbe. I gifted Divinity 1 and Divinity 2 to my friends in Canada who play only on PlayStation 4. And they loved both to death. They played it twice. And they liked both really, really good. And they also enjoyed the port. So they were really happy with it. They did not complain about anything. It went really well. They had no problems, also no technical problems. And they enjoyed the game a lot. Really a lot. I would recommend you to play it. Yes. And both are really good. I mean, I did not play it on a console. But I can tell you, my friends, they played both and completed both. And really, really loved the experience a lot. On the PlayStation 4. Quest Pocket Meat? I still have to wait. I did not get any levels yet. We need to be level 14, I think. But yeah, so I can only tell you, Lisbe, what they told me. And they really loved the experience. And for them, it was really, really nice. Yes, independent, but there are some connections to the games. And if you play the other parts, you hear names and meet people, you read of them. You all read of them. Yeah, I mean, this is a little bit sad. I played Divinity, but what did I tell you when I played it? 5 years ago, I think? It's been a long time, so I don't remember what happened back there. And I don't even remember names, really, a lot. So, sadly, I don't have a close connection to the game. But I can imagine if you play now Divinity 1, and then afterwards Divinity 2... that you then really feel the connection between the games, yeah. The only problem is if you play with others, it can sometimes be a bit buggy, so save often goes for both parts, what I heard. Okay, that I don't know. Also, my friends, they did not play online or anything. They just played, also they played locally together, you know, in front of one TV. But they did not play online, so I can't say anything about the online part on the console. That I don't know, I'm sorry. But I can only tell you they love the game experience itself. I did not check my items. Okay, that's fine. Yeah, but yeah, good to know. Thank you, Senior. Did you also play it on console or only on PC? Okay, who? Oh, is this a demon guy here? Oh yeah. Oh, look at him. Can we talk to him? Mordkahn.
Nothing good will come of speaking with them. They may sound merely mad, but they're infinitely more clever than you imagine. They move between moods like wind through trees, only to settle upon the one that may just sway you. They'll talk themselves out of that cage if you let them. You'll be their key before you know it.
Okay. Good. Okay, we're not allowed in his house. It's a really nice game. Also, one other problem I have sometimes when I fight, but not often, misclicking with my mouse. Not sure how it would be if you use controller or platform. That I don't know. Also, I have it here with the mouse too, that I really not really can click so well on stuff. I played with a controller one evening that worked really good. Aside of the inventory management, I think is easier. But I think in general for such a game, they made it really fine. But yeah, I just decide. Usually I play with the controller always. But for this one, I decided now to go with keyboard and mouse. Oof. Ooh, okay, wait. Let me save. I'm not sure if this lady will attack me immediately. Happens less often with Divinity 2. That's interesting. I don't remember it from Divinity 1, when you ask me, but it's too long ago. So I really don't remember. But if you would ask me now, I would say Divinity 1 was easier to click on stuff. But, you know, it's so long ago. I mean, when you play a good game, at least that's what happens with me. You know, and after some years, you only remember the good stuff. And you don't, also at least I don't remember, you know, the bad things. It's all gone. So I just remember I loved it. I liked it. Liked it so much that we played it even twice in a row. And yeah, it's a great game. And I can highly recommend it. But I don't remember more. I mean, even though I loved the game and the story, I don't remember it also. I mean, it's just too long ago. Which is interesting. It's but same with other games. For example, I can tell you Witcher 3. I loved it a lot. But the main is really good. I really remember is the first big quest, the Baron quest, which is also the most impressive one. Also, like, you know, most memorable because of the way how it's told the story. And yeah. There's a dead rabbit.
There's a boat at the dock.
Yeah.
Perhaps it may take us to the island.
Oh. Ah, so. Oh. This is everything is death fog. Oh, there's someone. The dead ferryman. Bridge to Blood Moon Island. Yeah, I'm not sure if we should go there now. Okay, wait. We go not now, they're not. Should I talk to him? Watch out, a Deathhawk? Yeah, I think it will kill me, right? And that is story? Yeah, it is. Yeah, it is. My ending, also my when I played first time Witcher 3. My Baron ending was the most disastrous fool what you can have. Everything was just sad and bad. And when I played it on stream again, it was better. Better. Even so, the story is still yeah, tough. Does not kill undead on a living. Where's the mama? Ah, da, okay. If you're in there, you get sauce. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, Zucker. I don't need sauce. I can just like here click on my bedroll. I get sauce like that. But yeah, Lisper, the game is really nice. Also, what I can recommend you, I have to play the game still myself, Pillars of Eternity. The first part, I gifted to my friends also for PlayStation, and they were really in love with the game also. They really liked the experience a lot. I did not give them so far Pillars of Eternity 2, because there I read on the Amazon reviews that the port is poorly. But I'm not sure if that's true, because the first one was so good, but the second one had some technical problems. But it's been a... Oh god, what is this? But it's been a while ago. So I thought if I get a good offer, I will give them the game to Christmas or birthday. Because maybe it's already, you know, like updated now and there were patches. You know what I mean? So, you tried playing Pillars? You didn't really get into it? I did not try it. I owned the game for a long time, but I heard about Pillars of Eternity. So many good things. Looks like a big nope. Yeah, this dude looks really mean, no? Lamenting Abomination. But we try it. I will save it, okay? Good night, Galfon. Thank you so much for joining. The Valence Sweet Dreams. Are you ready, guys, to die? Help me, please, my lord. What did he say? Hello?
What is that thing?
I don't know. Oh, can't we?
Please, Lord, spare me. Spare me. It is too much. My heart, too much. You cannot come here. I'm not done. I.
The creature suddenly holds itself around the ears, as though seized by a great pain. Several flapping jaws open and close over a single many-fanged maw, like a taxidermist's experiment.
Go!
Lower your voice. Gently tell the creature it appears to be in terrible pain.
Why are you here? Why do you come here?
Say you have to come to pray to the Seven at the altar he's guarding. Ask what he's doing here. Ready your weapon, you won't turn your back to this hulking beast. Zoom in. I can't zoom more. Now I can't do any zooming. But he has several heads or several mouths. Looks like there's like several. Yeah, oder? After dialogue? Okay. Ask what he's doing here.
His frantic gaze passes from the blood-stained altar to you. Comprehension suddenly clears the agony from his face.
He wants blood. He wants blood. My lord, I'll give you blood. I'll give it all. I beg you, my lord. Accept.
Okay, can you stop to move? I want to see your face. Oy, oy, oy. Okay. Yeah. I can't see him much because he's just like in the wall. wait. Maybe. He's shy? Yeah, he has several mouths, though. He really just walked into the wall. Here, now you can see him. You're like the fortune teller for Isa. You always know what are coming events before the others. Not really this bill. It's more, you know, it's more usually they bring stuff on the test server and then you can a little bit guess from the past how it will come. So. I mean, that the Midyear Mayhem comes in June, I did not expect. I was guessing that they will do something Thief's Guild Dark Brotherhood celebration event in May, but okay. So Midyear Mayhem event in June was not like what I expected, but it's now on the PTS. And it was on the PTS last week. Now we have the Pan Elsewhere event on the PTS, which is quarter three. And I guess it will be July. But that's a guess. I don't know it. But yeah, it's like Elsewhere celebration event. So you can prepare dailies in southern and northern elsewhere for that if you like. Okay, so let's go fighting, guys. Fighting! So, let's do some buffing. I have no clue if we can fight this dude. By the way, guys, I don't know if I'm strong enough for that. So, but yeah. It's on the PTS now. Okay. What is that stuff what he has there? There is a vampire? The wolfies are vampires? Oy, oy, oy. It's effect. They're not vampires. Okay. Is it from him? Okay. So, drain magic armor from target. So. Okay, I just drained his magic stuff. So I will just shield myself here. And then we do... We call a wolfie friend. Like... Here, so the wolfies can't come up. Maybe? Or... Maybe here. Woo! Encourage. So, bite him. Oh, he's too far away. Oh, why can't Lose attack? Can you believe it? Dragons in their own homeland. Exactly. Yeah. Yeah, how many wolfies are there? Ay, ay, ay. Ah, so Lose is knocked down. Oh, okay. I see. Oh my god. Did he steal my source point or what? Wow. Oh my god. Yeah, okay. Okay, okay. Good, good. Understood, guys. Understood. Yeah. I understood. Sorry. I understood. This dude is too strong for me now. Okay, I got it. He's really a strong guy. he's a really, really, really strong monster. He really doesn't want to show you. I try now to zoom in before we approach him. Ooh. How many eyes? Oh, wow. So he has, what, four faces? Oder so? It one, two, nee, more. Or one, two, three. He's several. He has several. Oh, also here, I see. Yeah, there's here several heads. Oh, and he also here. Oder? And the hands? Yeah, his head is also, so you see? This head is normal, but you see this hand here? It's also several wolf heads, oder? But yeah, he's strong. Ay, ay, ay. He's strong. Okay. Yeah, I would say. Big boss. Yeah. Okay, so we have on this map several things to fight. Where was the other dude? That stuff is the gun. I don't know why, but wait, we went. Was like Baker's cave? Where was it? I don't know why it got removed. Ah, nee, it's here. Ah, here. I did not see it because the red flag was over it. Also here, okay. Here's the other one, okay. But then we have everything here. Side of the water. Yeah, I wanted to go first and we talk now with our god. Okay. I did not think that we are so weak, but we just take like a fly. It was just like tot. Oder? Just like a fly. They were so strong. Did we here find everything?
I've spotted something.
Treasure! Ooh! A legendary sword! Nice! Here's the skeleton lady. Okay, so I think then I have everything. Oh, what's this one here? I thought it's a troll. Only beta trolls hide under bridges. Nee. Ach so, this is a different troll, oder? Yeah, I think this is a different troll. Wait. We're now here. Ja. Stimmt, hier war der andere Troll. War der Troll before? Nee.
Back off, Pigeon! This is my bridge, and I don't suffer fools on it.
The enormous, unusually red troll looms over you with his fists clenched threateningly. His expression is stern, yet you can see the tiniest twinkle in his intelligent eyes.
Didn't hear me the first time, parrot.
Say you heard him fine. He doesn't suffer fools, and you're not a fool. Shuffle from toe to toe and apologize for your intrusion. Tell him you're not used to talking insults from walking walks. I think we said this one.
He smiles a jagged and magnanimous grin. Each pitchfork pointed tooth seems to threaten you individually.
We'll see. You want to cross my bridge?
This bridge, say that you're pretty sure taxpayer coin constructed this bridge. Side-eyeing the dead Void Vulcan, say you don't want to end up like that. Not an ass to cross the bridge.
Well, I killed them. Nobody crosses my bridge for free, and they didn't pay the toll. Mind you, they hadn't tongues to bargain with, nor pockets for coin. But still...
I like him.
A troll must stand by his principles.
Ach so? Ask how this principles mesh with extorting money for the use of a public bridge. Yeah, I would save and ask that.
Look at this wreck. No taxpayer coin has touched it in a hot century.
He kicks the edge of the bridge, sending a sizable chunk of rock flying perilously close to your eye.
I'm the only thing standing between this bridge and the void. These days, everything is in decline.
Back away with your hands raised.
If you won't pay, you can't stay.
Okay. So. We got a quest. On the ropes? No. Which quest was it? We have so many quests. Journey to Arx. Find the advocate. Investigate Blood Moon Island. Generous offer. Black Pits. Black Pits. Ah, we have to go there back. But I don't know. Deal with Grog the Troll. We met a large and intelligent bridge troll by the name of Grog. He demanded a stupidly expensive bridge troll. I don't know. Do we have to go here anyway? Why do we have to go here? How did I go last time? We didn't. So did I go around here?
If you have to think, why not think big?
We did not go here. I was just like here. I went just here around, oder? Ookili, how are you? You're good? Awesome. I hope you're a great day. I'm a little bit on a Dragon Age for the quest and the NPC dialogues. Yeah, a little bit, yeah.
Back so soon?
He rubs his leathery hands together with glee.
Sure, sure. One regular what? Prized bridge crossing coming right up. And I don't want to hear any whiny little baby noises about it either.
I raise an eyebrow and tell him there's another void vocal on the bridge right behind him. Intentions persuasion, tell him that there'd be dead or charging less since more people could cross that way. Strength, flex your biceps and tell him you're willing to do this hard way. Draw your weapon. After there's anything you can do to lower the cost.
His eyes narrow to glinting slits and a deep laugh shakes his whole frame.
There is one thing, the competition. Take out my competition and I could waive the usual fee.
Look around, you don't see any competition here.
A little magpie feather named Mog. He's not fit to be a bridge keeper.
No?
He took over the other bridge across. And he's too cheap. I can't compete with his ridiculous prices.
Time to give him to location, you see what you can do.
That's a little non-committal, but I'll take what I can get around here.
Grog drags a rough map in the dust of the bridge with one claw. He then spends an inordinate amount of time sketching a highly vulgar doodle of this Marge he wants you to take care of.
There. Now, for the moment, you'll need to back off. No pay, no stay.
I love him. I love him. Even so, he seems to be a little bit mean, but still I like him. Okay. Ah, so here was the book. Okay. Let's save. Can go here around. Wait, oh, I go the wrong way, oder? Yeah. My orientation is sometimes a bit tough in this game. I don't know why, I find it sometimes just tough to see where we are. Anak, also let's see. We have to go here down. This way. We could also have ported, but I was like, maybe we missed something when we went here around. So I just wanted to be sure that we take a look. Here before the lich. Okay. Interesting. But his trolls are cool. Even so, he wants a lot of money. I mean, we could have paid that one, but yeah. Got a quest, right? So. Oh. Oh! Oh, did he get killed by the leech guy? Ooh. Hallo?
The spirit scrunches his face in frustration. He flails his hands and arms, but you don't understand the gestures. The Magister's spirit waits for relief that never comes.
I think he got killed by the Lich. Maybe. Huh?
I'll stop your play. Take that, sorcerer. Dallas, get her.
You're dead, Alexander. Alexander, you're dead. You have to stay dead until we say you're not dead anymore.
Here, mister. Alexander doesn't have to stay dead, does it? Hey, are you an elf?
Wait, that is an elf? Alexander, you very much hope he stays dead? The kids that rules are made to be broken. Alexander can come back to life if he wants to.
See? Told ya. Take that, sorcerer. Come on, Dallas. Help me put a collar on her.
Turtle Johnny puts an invisible sauce collar on Mary Lane.
Take that, sorcerer. No more saucy sorcery for you. Alexander and Dallas save the world again.
I hate this game.
Point out that if Alexander can come back from death, a sorcerer can learn how to break a source collar.
The three kids stare at you in awe.
Yeah.
Crack! The source collar's broken. I'm free. How about you, Dallas? I'll kill you again, Alexander. I'm a big bad sorcerer. Woohoo!
Woohoo!
For a moment, you watch the children play. Then you leave them to it.
Woohoo! So soon we do my favorite stuff, inventory management. Where are my friends? Hey! Oh, come on, are you kidding me? Look where they are! They did not follow me since forever. Just because of a little bit poison? Are you serious? I you know, sometimes this game is weird. So. Are they walking to us? Nah. Na gut. We can do that. Dragon Age was also a great game. We're looking forward to Dragon Age 4. I hope it will be amazing. Oh, we are united. Ta-da. Made it.
Welcome back. Your steadfast loyalty is greatly appreciated.
Bromwin, hey, thank you very much. 5 months already. Thank you so much for your support. It's really, really appreciated. Thank you so, so much. How are you doing? This house?
Where is it? Where is it? Sir, please, have you seen a small burlap pouch lying about?
Say you haven't seen any such pouch?
Blast! It's gone for good, I fear.
She rubs a hand over her smooth head, then suddenly looks up at you. Her great greenish-gold eyes are alive with worry.
There isn't any chance you could spare a moment to help me look, could you? I wouldn't dare ask it if it weren't terribly important.
Take somewhat aback by her surprising beauty, you know, then ask what you can do. Smile, ask her what you should start, where you should start looking.
Tears star her eyelashes and she begins to weep. She takes your hand.
I know. What a crybaby I am. It's just... you're so kind. In the pouch... I really must find it back, or my master will flay me alive. It had quite a sum inside it.
Ask her who she serves. Ask her if she should start looking.
Magister Raymond. He bade me take the coins to purchase supplies for his journey, but I dropped it along the way. He's sure to think I stole it.
She tilts her head back and blinks back tears.
I'd never do such a thing. Never.
Tell her she can surely find work here in Driftwood and earn the gold back within a few days. Apology for missing amount. I think she is just making this up and she just wants to rock me. With a lot of bling bling eyes. Oder? What do you say, guys? Is it about bling bling eyes? Dashing June. Okay, let's see. I save and I will just give her the money and we'll see what will happen.
You're... Gods, you're so terribly kind. But I couldn't accept such lavish charity. I just... It's so unbecoming.
Hold out the coins and insist. Tell her not to think of his charity, but as two people looking out for another. Not until you at least keep an eye out for the pound. Pouch. Not everyone is born in a bed of comfortable as yours. This is the right thing to do. Okay, we just make this.
I don't know what to say. Your kindness is overwhelming.
She accepts the coins, letting her hand linger over yours for the briefest of moments.
You don't know what this means to me. I'll send word to Magister Raymond right away. He should send for me soon enough. Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, you're welcome.
Magister's dropping left and right. Can't say I'm shedding any tears.
Is this a Magister thingy? A pup? Oh, they're toilets, no? Yeah, look here, toilets.
Hmm, I'll stay out of this.
Occupied!
What?
Oh! Unholy hell!
Oh my god. Ask her if she's alright.
Do I sound like I'm alright?
Oh my god.
That's what I get. Bloody tainted stew!
Didn't he ask what she means, tainted stew?
Makes a little, no, fish into some of my stew. Bloody mackerel must have been tainted. Save me, Lucian!
Whoa, was
in that blasted...
New recipe! Oh my god. Okay, guys, don't eat tainted stew, okay? It's not so good for you.
Oh,
they put really a lot of love into this game, really. I mean, there are so many small details, they put really a lot of love in it. And it's really pretty, also.
What's this? I found something.
Treasure! Oh! The cats. Oh! Oh no! We digged up a dead cat. Here.
What do you want? Can't you see I'm busy?
Busy? Say the chickens don't know what busy means. Tell you a bit peckish. Does she have any eggs to spare?
Peckish? Is that a joke of some kind? If it is, it's only a little funny. But you tried, and that's something. So will you take an egg for your effort?
Thank you.
Well, ain't you a tall drink at all, Ness? What can I do for you, honey?
Admire the sheen of her feathers.
She fluffs them and coos.
You're so very, very sweet to notice, honey. Ain't easy keeping him so nice in a dusty town like this. But I do take pride in him.
Wonder if she's got any eggs that she's willing to give you.
Sure, why not? Not all of them hatch, you know. And between you and me, honey... I don't mind the taste of an omelette now and again. Go on and scoot then, honey.
Oh, oh God. Ja gut. Ja gut. See? Even chickens like omelette. Das ist Saudis. Okay, now we go back to the... How she ever she was called. To Meister. Genau, we go back to Meister. And then we should have a meeting with our God. This way. Yeah, Hier. Count it. Voice actors did a great job. Yes, they did really good job. Really. Also they put really a lot of love into this game. Also Divinity 1. Fantastic. Also everything is voiced there. Everything. So we're back here. And what did I have to do? I forgot. I had to... Wait. Open. Quest items. Open. I had to use bloody thing and then we had combine with whisper if you don't get I collect a lot of this bloodwood thingy. Ingredients. What does it look like? Wizard. Blood Rose. Where's Bloodroot? Next to the dagger. Oh, thank you. Wow, I thought it would be red. Thank you. I thought it would be red. You know, like, also it's called Blackroot. I said always Bloodroot. Oops. Yeah, good. And you reading helps, right? And then this one. Does it work? Okay. Ah, so we need fire, right? So, and not like that. So. Okay, so I made... So. Itchable. On the ground. And then... we save. So now we needed fire. And thank you, Zelina. It's really appreciated. Thank you very much. I would have looked, searched much, much longer. Okay, now we needed fire, right? So.
As you suck the smoke deep into your lungs, your vision starts to swim and cloud. There is an intense pounding in your head, and you can feel the world fading. As the world fades away, you lose all sense of being grounded. You reach out, but you could feel yourself falling slowly, sinking into the depths of your own soul.
You said, oh, but he did not die, oder? Okay, so we are back at the god's place. It's a little bit spooky also. There he is. Hello.
He winces and recoils, then quickly regains his composure.
My, my. How you positively brim with sauce. No wonder, after all the adventures you have had. All the things you have had to do.
He's assuming an air of levity, but he's clearly unwell. Ask him what's wrong.
Oh, it's naught but a chill. Bit drafty in your soul, that's all. You should...
A sudden shudder jolts through his body so violently that he drops to his knees, stunned into silence.
Bless him, speak the spell immediately.
Source washes over him, a wave over a single flame. But unlike last time, it seems to have precious little effect. an ancient curse escapes from his lips, spoken so forcefully that for a brief moment, all light recedes into the webs of darkness.
Ask him if you're right. You thought you were about to lose him.
I have told you before, the void is stronger than ever. But so are you. I can sense the expanse of source inside you. You are ready to learn the spell I have yearned to teach you. The spell you will need when we reach the Well of Ascension. I have given you eyes that see the source. Now I will give you the teeth to take it.
Tyr Zendelia smiles, and you notice for the first time two vampire-like fangs glistening beneath his upper lip. A gulf of magic envelops you, and you feel a sudden, insatiable hunger for source.
Go on, I am here for you. Give in to your hunger.
You shake in anticipation, tell him you feel ravenous and powerful at the same time. Despite the overwhelming urge, say this is too dangerous, he is weak, he invites you to take from him.
Do not heed me or any other, only your own lust for power, just like a god should.
I give it.
Go on. Devour me.
What? Okay. Consume a corpse to gain source point or steal a source point from a living character.
Though your spell tore through him like a spear through flesh, Tyr Zendelius looks grimly happy, if haggard.
You speak the spell with brash ferocity. Like I knew you would, my champion.
Say that was quite invigorating, but you still wonder of the true nature of the spell. Remark that from now, from the look of him, too much ferocity was had. Tell him the hunger gave you hasn't quite abated.
Oh, do you still not see? Even though you are a god woken, destined to be a god? Let me tell you the one truth about what it means to be a god. It is to be the lion in a world of lambs. It is about power. And power is not given. It is taken. With your all-seeing eyes and your all-consuming teeth. You can see the souls of the dead. And now you can feed from them to your hungry heart's content. So feed. For you will starve until you finally feast upon the Well of Ascension.
Damn, this spell doesn't sit well with you at all. It is force of destruction, not creation.
By all means, fast, if you must. But your hunger will soon trump your all too delicate feelings. Your soul must grow bigger still. Your inner self become a vaster expanse so that it may house divinity. There are more masters of the source. More aspects of the source to learn. The hunt continues. Just you hurry.
Okay. Are you still here?
The spirit keeps glancing back. A difficult task since his shoulders are tense as iron.
How can I help?
Consume the chronicle source. Nah. Okay, so we can go out, I guess.
You seem different. Tell me, what have you learned? Or has the smoke simply addled your mind beyond repair?
She's really pretty, oh, Meister Siva. Did you learn how to drain source from creatures?
Vampirism? As if killing a creature weren't enough, you should utterly destroy its soul too. A dark skill, but certainly useful.
The Meister slumps back in her chair, closing her eyes. Her breathing is shallow and ragged.
Very well, then. But as you lack the glowing eyes of the divine, or the purpose of one soon to be divine, I trust you need more source.
Yep.
Thankfully, the Magisters have made our lives very simple. They carefully catalogued every sorcerer in this area, keeping careful records in their barracks. The gentle and weak were captured, collared and shipped to... Fort Joy. The powerful masters were deemed too dangerous or insane to confront, which means they may still be open to a teaching position. Do not look at me like that. I said it was simple, not easy. Now get to the Magister's barracks and find that list. You no longer have the luxury of time.
Okay. So, this time, I will take the bowl with me, right? So we don't want that I have again a problem like last time that I don't know where it is. So open. Okay, so we do the black root, nee, blood root, nee, black root, the sword, and the ritual thingy here, quest items. Okay, so.
Welcome back. Your steadfast loyalty is greatly appreciated.
Hey, it's it, Buffo. Thank you so much for resubscription. 23 months. Welcome back, my friend. Thank you very, very much. It's it, Buffo saying, look no further for kindness than Tier 9's community, which has grown from Tier 9's warmth and good energies. May the force be with you always. Thank you so much, said Buffo. Welcome back. How are you doing? Thank you very, very much for your kind words. Okay. So we have here some clothes. Seaweed. So we make this to wears magical stuff. Oh wow, this is a lot. We have here one-handed sword. Let's identify that one. North Rose. One-handed. Oh, this is stronger. One strength. Can we take this one? And this one we can do to wares. This place Firestorm Trap. Okay. So. Okay. So we have this one can also go to wares. Oh, whistle. Okay. Oh, save. Change the anchor. So, let's go back. So now. They told us we should go to the Magister's barracks, but where are they? I have no clue. Here, maybe? Where the ship is? Maybe? I mean, this is the pub, the sorcerer's house. This is the Magister's house. Huh. I'm not sure if it's like there somewhere in the house. Let me see. Look for more Blackwood. Closed. Closed. Whatever's if we have him first. Oh, okay. Ah, so. Search for the Carlwoods. Where are they? Carlwoods. Here.
Oh, that's he. Ah! That's every talk with the elf lady. She was so mean. Okay. Paladin checkpoint. Hiker's Nest. This one. This one we got. Okay. So here was the. What's here? Black Pit. Not that mean elf again? Yeah, that was this lady. And she's still probably too strong for us, I guess. She's probably still too strong. Okay. So. Driftwood Dunes. Boat. Ah, so here we started. Okay. Bitchkeeper's House. Pitch to Blood Moon. Abundant Lifewood Soul. Ah, so there we have to also go. Boomby. Okay, we go maybe in this direction then. Okay, we port here. So, then we go. Nee, not this way. We want to go here. Oh, the music is so nice. Okay, the mean elf should be here somewhere. And we are now level 12. And we met her, we were weaker. She's level 14. We could try now to fight again if you want.
This looks like an elven proving ground, but I've never seen one for myself.
Elven structure? Calwood Mill. Tongue of Flame. 10,000 XP.
The totem stands dormant.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Explore a little bit more. Calwood's Mill. Oh, we found the people now.
Go no further. We are at ritual. Do not disturb us.
Okay, we can say memory. Say it's urgent that you're allowed to pass. Claim that you're allowed to speak with an elder elf. They gave you permission to pass. Tell the elf to relax your kin. After all, you mean no harm. Respond to the guard with a traditional elven greeting and say that you wish to bear witness to the ritual.
Enter then. Keep respect.
I see you. We are in ritual for a fallen brother. You may talk to Tova. Do not break ritual.
Ask about the elf who was subject of the burial. What happened to them?
The elf is Sarius. He dies in battle against lone wolves. Our ritual honors him and hastens his return as an ancestor tree.
Express your sympathies for the loss of the brother at arms. Not that the lone wolves are formidable fighters, perhaps it was unwise to go against them.
Thank you. Sarius dies well. Dies as an elf warrior.
Ask what the elves are doing in this region.
Only Tova can speak to you of this. She will decide what you should know or not. We have little, but what we have we may trade. A fair bargain. Wood,
birth to birth.
Okay.
I see you.
Okay, that went quite okay.
Three battle-weary elven warriors make ritual over the body of a fallen comrade. They're chanting low and fierce. The pain of their losses manifest in every word.
Blood to earth, to wood, to birth. The blood of Sarius to this earth.
Whisper the referral, blood to earth. Offer a prayer to Tyr Sedilus for the response of Saria's soul. Hold your tongue, you know not this Sarias.
The tallest, strongest elf, whom you take to be the leader, acknowledges your presence with the tiniest tilt of her head, then turns back to the task in hand. She places the tip of a long-bladed spear on poor dead Sarius's chest bone.
Blood to earth.
Her companions reach out and grasp the spear, ready to plunge it into Sarius's heart.
Blood to earth.
Together you plunge the blade deep into Sarius's heart, then twist it three times as is the custom. Blood flows freely to the ground, and Sarius's heart lies neatly cut in four.
Blood to blood!
Each warrior plucks a piece of heart and places it in their mouth. Chewing solemnly, their leader looks to you to see what you will do.
To great respect, take a piece of heart, but put it in your mouth and chew.
Sarius's memories flood you. A warrior, proud and true, you fight the lone wolves at the sawmill for Sahela, your scion, and for the future of all the elves, or all that still remain. But the fight goes ill. You and Tova draw fire that your friends may flee. You die in Tova's arms.
Give Tova's a slow nod of respect to share memory now.
With the barest blink, Tova accepts your good wishes, then turns back to the corpse.
Sarius is a warrior, proud and true. Blood to blood, earth to earth, wood to wood, birth to birth. Sarius becomes his tree. May Sarius take root.
The elves pick Sarius's bloody corpse from the ground. Tova looks to you, then indicates for you to help. Together you send Sarius to his final resting place. His corpse rolls to a stop at the bottom of the pit. The elven leader stands and stares at her fallen comrade. Then she wipes away a tear and turns away.
Oha, we got something. We got some pants, fancy pants. Constitution, fire, HP. Bone couriers, for strength. It's for, what would be one summoning? Okay. One strength, one necromancer, one summoning. War cane. Shadow Whisperer. What's that? A staff. Now we take this one. It could maybe go for Lose. Also wait, we have boots.
Once all are well, once more we take the mill.
And
kill the lone wolves all.
Lose.
Find that wound that it does not fester.
What? Oh, she can't take it? Oh no! What? She doesn't have it. She's only enough strength because of this armor. Okay. Too bad. Maybe you? One strength. Two summoning. Wow. Why do you have so much summoning? That's really... Okay. Yeah, maybe we should have to change also soon his armor. When I remove his armor, then he does not... we have to remove the headpiece, the chest, and the hands, because otherwise he's like cursed. So maybe we just save it. And then we need... When we get more armor now, then we can maybe exchange also his stuff. He was level 6 what he has, so...
The tree-form spirit slowly, oh so slowly, becomes...
I see you.
I wanted to ask with him.
The tree-form spirit slowly, oh so slowly, becomes aware of you. When he speaks, it's low and slow. He grumbles, as if in discomfort or in pain.
I see you.
Offer the traditional elven greeting and ask him how he died.
A lone wolf took my life as I tried to take hers. She fought the battle well, at least as well as I. The mill ran red with blood. Much of it was mine.
Notice pain, ask if the agony of violent death lingers on.
No, not at all. This pain right now is from taking root. This pain is good. This pain is life.
Ask the spirit how you would learn from his mistakes.
Talk your way inside. Talk gently and tell lies, or creep and crawl. There is a way, a secret way inside. Search and you will find. Fight if fight you must, but do not dare to hope to kill them all. But if you can, please kill them all.
With a last great creaking groan, he returns to the business of securing his roots and takes his leave of you.
Okay.
I see the good in you.
Tell the shaman you spoke to the spirit of Sarias he's taking root.
The shaman searches your eyes for a sign that you might be lying.
You speak the truth. Your news is good. Many trees are lost to the death fog, and the ritual does not always work. This is not a well of souls, but a simple pit. We stand ritual more in hope than faith.
A single tear appears at the corner of one eye, but he ignores it.
We may yet live on, we elves. I see the good in you. I see the bad in you. I see the all of you.
You summon a bar of chocolate? Enjoy. Bon appétit.
I see you.
Respond as at custom. I see the good in you. Ask how she came to be injured.
Worry not. The wound tells the eye a lie. In truth, the pain is not so bad. The lone wolf in the mill, who cuts me so, has luck upon his side. For now, not so our own dear Sarius.
Know that Sarius' ritual is done, at least he has found rest.
If his tree may grow, perhaps he may find rest. The shaman knows about these things, not I.
Ask about Tova.
Tova is our hope. Tova leads the way.
I see the good in you. You may see the good in me, even injured.
Ask how she was hurt.
I fight. I do not win, and I do not die. It is this way from the moment we left our homeland. From the moment the mists of death descend.
Praise the warrior for keeping up the fight in the face of the annihilation brought on by the death fog. Ask where they came here after they left their homeland.
We fight for our lives as we fight all our lives. We fight the black ring on the side of the divine. But Lucian betrays us. Lucian sends us to our deaths. And so we fight and fight again. And fight until the moment where we find our home once more.
Note that the loss of the homeland is a great one, but the loss of the Skyon would be greater.
Our loss is great. And so we fight, that our victory may be greater.
The tall elf stares into the pit with dry, bloodshot eyes, her face betraying no emotion.
We lose too much. We lose our homes, we lose our safety, we lose each other.
She looks into your eyes, her face set in a fierce frown.
Oh, you've also chocolate, Inaya? Ay, ay, ay.
It is enough. No more.
Tell her you understand how she feels. You've lost so much yourself. Tell her this is a time of great loss. Not your people have suffered too much, far too much.
Yes. It is as though Tyrus and Dilius himself forgets us. There is no fate for us but the one we make. You honor us during the ritual. You honor Sarius. You help remember him. You help bury him. But we need help still, or we perish here. Not only these people here, but all of us. I wonder if you honor us once more.
Okay, ask what she needs.
It is something of great importance
of
to
course.
Me and to our people.
What do you need?
Our home forests are gone. The great trees are cut to pieces. The memories inside them nearly lost. They become nothingness unless we find our scion.
Say you've heard of scions before. Ask after the scion she seeks. What is their name? Where were last seen? A scion? What does she mean? Tell her you wish her luck, whatever she is. You've heard of scions before. They are like seeds containing all elvish memories, a safeguard against destruction. Express your concern, a scion has been lost.
Not lost. Taken. All our memories. Everything the ancestor trees knew. Our seed for the future. Stolen from us. She is...
Her voice catches in her throat.
She is my daughter. Her name is Sahela, and she is taken from us. That is why we come here. That is why we lose Sarius, to find her. If she is lost, if our scion is lost, all our people are lost. She is everything.
You know where she is?
Her eyes narrow, her fists clench, and her mouth tightens to a thin line.
Do you know the lone wolves?
Not.
Then you know the risk. We come here to get her back, to bring her home. She is everything to me. She is everything to us.
Sahela, say you met her daughter while you were in Fort Joy.
You do. You speak to her. Then you understand. You see what a gentle soul she is. You see how kind. She is not only a scion, but a precious child. She cannot be lost.
So you try to find her, ask for any information that might help.
You honor us. I fear it is impossible for one of my kind to enter their base. They know we are here. They expect us. But you have been away from the tribes. It is in your speech. It is in the way you walk. Perhaps you have a chance still. She is taken by their leader, a savage man named Roost Anlon. I do not know why, but I know she must return to me. If I lose her, I cannot lose her. We plan another assault. We cannot give up. It is better for us all to die than for Sahela to be lost. I only hope perhaps you find her before then. Good luck.
Okay. We need a lot of XP to level up, oh? No? We're now for ages. Oh, wait. I just clicked on the map. I thought the map will tell me something where we have to go, right? But no. We have caramel, okay. We have Mano Mozart. Okay, what is that? With marzipan?
Heal your wounds. We need you standing.
Healed or not, I fight.
Okay. Okay, so Elven Camp. Allied Spirit, Abundant Life. Elven Structure. And we can go here. There's a treasure. Do you have an orange mouse in your chocolate? So Oh, this is all Deathfog. Okay. I have to be really careful. I have no clue how we can go on the island when everything is full of Deathfog. Oh, there's a frog. Hello.
These river guys will shoot you through if you get too close. I'm gonna try and slip through the back way myself. I like a river challenge.
What's this? I found something.
Treasure! Aha, from the heroes. We got Justinia's favor. Armor and gold. See? So we got... I can take this one. Nice. They're really nice. So... let's identify this one. New chest armor. Oof, wow. It is strength armor. 158 physical armor. Wow. 158. Crazy. Gloves. Okay, you know what? So, okay, I remove his armor. He will get now this one and this one. We need a helmet for him, so still, but I mean, these two have so much more armor than the other one. It's like crazy. It's crazy. Ay, ay, ay. And here. I can have this one. So. Okay. We just need then, just need for him a new helmet. Nice. You have also chocolate, Harkonnen. So we have a chocolate party. Can't move, I'm crippled. Wieso, I'm crippled? Achso. Okay, now it's okay. Why we are crippled? But do we still have some... Achso. I know. We need also boots for him. Oder? And trousers also? Oof. Okay, so he needs also trousers. Oh yeah, naja. Okay, he just has now gloves and armor. Okay, I hope we don't have to fight. We need to loot a little bit, guys. I guess it's okay. I mean, he just walks around now in pants. It's warm here.
I suspect these skulls were left here as a warning. Don't expect a welcome.
Help from long work. Oh, again, so much work. You never have a break, or? The end of the week. Oh,
this is blasphemy. Don't look, Quercus.
What's this?
The forest will reclaim his hell's cape when the time comes.
You had also chocolate today, gonna take? Nice. Stuff. Why can't we get some boots? Can we just send this one to Lose? Let's see. This one is nice. Intelligence and summoning. That's really nice. 3 intelligence, 1 summoning. That's really nice stuff. Really nice. Then we have some armor. Physical armor. And what? 30 physical armor and 158 magical armor. Ay, 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 ay. Wow. That's crazy. No? This is really crazy. He's level 14 stuff. And we are level 12. Oh, awesome! Quantitech. Go this way? Can we just go here inside? I have no clue. Slumber check. You've got nerve stalling out of a restricted area. Attempt a bribe. What? He cast me into the water? What happened now? Okay, wait. Now we have to fight against everyone? Oh, I thought we can just talk. No talking. Tick. They're level 14. I'm not sure if we can make that. Oh, yeah, there are a lot, huh? Can you know what? This is a really huge fight. Think this will take longer. That looks like a long fight. Didn't get any sweets after. Oh no, it's that buffer. But this looks like a fight which takes there were so many enemies. I thought there's only one, but I don't think we will make it in 5 minutes, so that is something what doesn't make sense. So we reload, then we can try tomorrow. I mean, this like looks like a huge area, the whole thingy here. Abundant life with sawmill. I mean, it looks like the whole place. So if we have to fight our way through that one, then we maybe do that tomorrow. So I'll just save now here. And then we stop. And then we can have tomorrow, can take it easy and explore the space in peace. Maybe before we fight, we could also get for our character, as for him, maybe some shoes and a helm and some boots. Pants and shoes and helm would maybe help for a big fight. but just maybe we could consider that we come back, with some proper gear. But just maybe. I mean, we can also try to make it a challenge and just try to fight naked. It's also fine. Ja. So. Okay, let's see who you're hosting. Who is there? There we go. Thank you so much, my friends, for joining. That's really, really appreciated. Thank you very, very much for the wonderful evening. Have a good night, said Buffer. Good night, Garrett. Sweet dreams, Killy. Thank you. And you can also cuddle your cats for me. Good night, said Buffer. Sweet dreams, Wootsy Louie. Good night, Inaya. Good night, Quantatic. Good night, Kyron. Thank you so much, my friends, for joining. It's really, really appreciated. Have a wonderful night. Sleep well and sweet dreams. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye. Tschüss. Good night. Good night, Lisbeth. Good night, Inaya. Bye-bye. Toodles.